Greatest threat to our planet is the belief that someone else would save it. A wonderful thought by Robert Swan to begin this video. World is packed with problems that, if not addressed, can cause permanent damage to the planet and thus humanity. These problems are the result of unjust equilibriums present in our society.
In any dynamic system, equilibriums are present. On closely observing, we find that social equilibriums are present. A society is said to be in a social equilibrium when subsystems dynamically adjust to changes. In society, we can find many stable yet inherently unjust equilibriums that are causes of exclusion, marginalization, and suffering of a segment of humanity. We, at Enactus IITR, believe in taking entrepreneurial action for setting new business that improve the lives of people and forge a new social equilibrium and thus unleashing new values in the society.
सुबह की पहली किरण से निकलना होता है, किताबों का बस्ता नहीं जनाब, कचरे का थैला टंगा होता है। दिन भर तप कर कभी 100 तो कभी 150 रुपए कमा लेता हूँ, बेबस हूँ, आंखों में आंसू हैं, पैरों में छाले हैं। इसके बावजूद भी खुद को खुश नसीब मान लेता हूँ। शाम होते होते थक जाता हूँ, कभी भूखा तो कभी प्यासा ही सो जाता हूँ। ये मेरी दासा है, कचरा चुगने वाले की कहानी है। आज तुम्हारी तो कल किसी और की चौखट पर पड़े प्लास्टिक का कूड़ा तुम सबके जगने से पहले ही उठा लेता हूँ। कह सकते हो नादान हूँ, पर अपना कर्म बखूबी निभाना जानता हूँ। दिस ब्यूटिफुल पोयम क्लियरली नरेट्स द मैसेज टू द ह्यूमन वर्ल्ड that these street vendors are the actual epitome of cleanliness and deserve the supreme respect from every hand of the society. Meet Abdul, a rag picker from a small area based on outskirts of Roorkee named Rampura. He's one of the 150 rag pickers who live in this area. Abdul's day begins as early as 4 in the morning. With his worn-out bags on his shoulders, he picks the refuse from the entire town, hunting for valuable plastic, glass in the filth from roadsides to huge garbage carts. All the recyclable waste from the city is brought to Rampura by rag pickers like Abdul. Once refuse is brought to this area, the rest of the day is spent in its minute segregation. Even plastic is further segregated into 17 different categories. Children and women are also involved in this process. The aim is to generate as much amount of sellable plastic as possible so that the earnings from it can feed the entire family. There are days when the money earned is enough, but most days it's not. The waste management supply chain distributes in various stakeholders, from rag pickers to business owners of big plastic waste recycling firms. Now the current scenario of the supply chain is biased towards the upper level stakeholders in terms of revenue and profit. These business owners own the heavy and expensive machinery used in plastic recycling along with the strong logistics network. On the other hand are these small rag pickers who can't even work independently and are obliged to work under the thekedars who offer them small loans. When our team at Enactus IIT Roorkee visited these rag pickers, we were left beyond words hearing the figures of their income. Imagine doing all this hard work for an income as low as 150 rupees a day. This is cheaper than what many of us spend on coffee. The rates for plastic waste was as low as 12 to 15 rupees per kg for PET and 10 to 12 rupees per kg for HDPE or LDPE. But what was more astonishing was that the thekedars who bought this plastic just shredded and sold it at about 25 to 30 rupees per kg. The profit distribution in this supply chain was unfair, yet socially acceptable. We realized that this was an example of a highly unfair equilibrium, which is the very reason for the exploitation of rag pickers, and decided to challenge the status quo. Scrap, which stands for Sustainable Collection Recycling and Processing of Plastic, is a project focused on making the entire plastic waste supply chain more efficient by involving ground-level people such as rag pickers and kabadiwalas, unifying and empowering them as a community to work together.
Our team took the action of modifying this supply chain, and for that we developed small-scale shredders at just 1/4 market cost for the rag pickers.
Now our community is capable enough to shred plastic easily with a shredding capacity of 25 kg per hour on their own and can sell it directly to the factory outlets in Mangalore. We started our pilot run with about 5 rag pickers by giving them our shredder and a place to work. They managed to collect as much as 35 kg of plastic waste in a day. In a span of 14 days, they were able to manage about 500 kgs of shredded plastic, which was then sold at a rate of 35 rupees per kg in the market, which means in 14 days they were able to generate a revenue of rupees 17,500. This implies that now the daily income increases to more than 250 rupees a day, which is approximately 67% more than their regular income. They realize that due to the low cost of shredder, it is more advantageous for them to buy the shredder and work as a community rather than choosing to work for the thekedar due to their debt allegations. Moreover, we are willing to lend them the shredders on easy installments and a zero interest rate. Our model helps them to multiply their profits, and now more and more rag pickers are willing to join, grow and prosper with us. Our model has attracted a lot of attention and has successfully gathered incubation and mentorship from various incubation challenges. The Subdivisional Magistrate of Roorkee has also recognized our efforts and has reached out to us for the expansion and welfare of such communities in the area. It has been a holy destination for Hindus since time immemorial. Devotees from all over the world come here to discover the Paramatma within. A daily average of 1 lakh tourists visit this holy city to offer their prayers and present the idols with flowers as offering. As these flowers represent the purity of devotion, it would be highly dishonorable to dispose them with the municipal waste. Therefore, most of these flowers are disposed of in the holy river Ganga. Now an intrinsic part of our traditions, and no one has questioned this existing system. Ganga has been a symbol of faith, hope, culture and sanity. The extraordinary faith and respect for River Ganga in India are as old as the Indian culture itself. Every year, 80 lakh metric tons of waste flowers are dumped into River Ganga. Floral waste reportedly accounts for 16% of total river pollutant. While rotting flowers affect the water quality, the pesticide used on them leach into water and harm marine life. We at Enactus ITR decided to come up with an idea to shift the suboptimal equilibrium to a more balanced one. We discussed, debated and finally decided to start the Project ARC, which aimed to upcycle flower waste and create a circular economy in the floral industry. A solution was to create marketable products like incense sticks from this floral waste to nudge the equilibrium in the right direction. So now, the cycle begins with the devotees bringing flowers to the temple, which are then used to make incense sticks to be used by the devotees again, creating a circular environment for the safe disposal of the floral waste. The CHNS test showed that an ARC Agarbatti is less polluting than any conventional incense sticks which are made from charcoal. Moreover, the proximity of Roorkee to Haridwar and Rishikesh provided us with a promising market opportunity. We believe we are not selling a product, rather endorsing a vision, a promise for a better future, a cleaner world, and a sustainable example for generations to follow. While trying to find a channel to implement our project, we encountered another issue that has persisted in our society for a long time, hindering our path to meaningful progress, the discrimination against women. This led us to create women communities at Anushruti and Piran Kalyar Dargah. Anushruti is a school for differently abled children inside the IIT campus. Mothers accompany their ward during school hours as they require a guardian supervision in their daily lives. When we contacted the principal of Anushruti, she told us that these women are eager to learn any skill that could help them earn money, as they come from homes with modest means and also have a lot of time at their hand while at school. So we came up with the idea to teach these women to make incense sticks. We trained them through regular workshops and provided all the raw materials. Our efforts yielded results soon, and at present, we have over 15 women from Anushruti working with us who earn around 2000 rupees per month through the sale of self-made incense sticks in the market of Rishikesh and Haridwar. Kalyar Dargah, located 5 km from Roorkee, generates around 40 to 50 kg of floral waste daily, which was earlier disposed of in the Ganga Canal. At present, we at Teamer procure these flowers before their disposal. As the Dargah area has high number of unemployed women, a regular flower waste supply along with a great market for Agarbatti, we thought creating a self-sustainable circular economy in this area would be profitable and convenient. We came in touch with a local NGO, the Spinal of Youth, working in the field of child education and women empowerment. The NGO introduced us to the women in the area who wanted to be a part of this initiative. Interested in the eco-friendly Arka Agarbatti with a sustainable production cycle, Earthly Tribe, a Delhi-based organic e-commerce startup, approached our team for a collaboration which is still in the pipeline. We also plan to replicate the Kaliya Darga model across various cities of India, starting with Akshardham in Delhi. As the three basic components of this model, floral waste, a workforce and a market for Agarbatti are bound to exist near any place of worship.
We at Earth do not aim to create an industry which is driven by sole motive of profit. Rather, aspire for a sustainable equilibrium by upcycling floral waste through a cost-effective production cycle, which entitles the suppressed woman to a sense of identity which extends well beyond the traditional scope of family. We promise an end product which empowers the oppressed, engages the market, and encourages the society. Teamwork believe that the woods are lovely, dark and deep, but we have promises to keep. And miles to go before we sleep. Miles to go before we sleep.
The world as we know it is transforming in its ways due to COVID-19 pandemic, with countries and communities all over the globe modifying their practices for sustenance. While the pandemic disrupts the conventional ways of living, we at Enactus ITR envision an opportunity to reflect upon the flaws of the existing equilibrium and aim for self-sustainable and impactful solution to ensure food security and a healthy lifestyle for the unprivileged society. We are a team of diverse individuals who come from all places of India and backgrounds to share a common goal of giving back to society and making this world a better place to live. Enactus, as it stands,
entrepreneurial action
for others,
creating a better world
for us all.